Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss our next chapter, that is natural vegetation, chapter 4. Here 5 different things we are going to learn. Number 1, natural vegetation, its meaning, importance of forest, types of forest in detailed way we will learn, reasons for the depletion of the forest and conservation of forest. That one also important, in detail way we will learn. So here number 3 and 5 I marked. These two I will discuss in detail. And 1, 2, 4, these three are also important but very easy for you. First, natural vegetation, its meaning. If I ask you, generally, students say natural vegetation means forest. No, forest is a type of natural vegetation. Forest is a natural vegetation, but not its meaning. Meaning here I have written. Can you see this one? Natural vegetation means any plants or trees that grow on their own naturally, without any form of human intervention. That is the meaning of natural vegetation. Very easy. Means natural vegetation means trees, forest, plants, because these things when form naturally, that is called natural vegetation. Now the importance of forest, I think all of you know about it. What are the importance of forest? Forest gives us timber, which we can use for construction purpose, which we can use for making furniture. Forest also gives us softwood, which is used to make the ply, paper. Except these two, it gives us fruits, gum, even medicines also. Forest can control flood, can reduce the soil erosion. I think very easy point, very easy topic, all of you know. So it is your homework. Here I am writing homework. Write any four points. Write any 4 points. Done. Importance of forest. Now, number 4. Reasons for the depletion of the forest. Yes, there are many reasons. This one also very easy question for you. Reasons for the depletion. One question here I have given. What are the main reasons for shrinkage in forest area? Same thing. Reason, that also you know. First of all, deforestation. Deforestation for timber collection. Deforestation for urbanization. Deforestation for industrialization. Shifting, cultivation, overgrazing. So these are the reasons. Many are there and all points are easy for you. So this reason, it is also your homework. Write any 4 points. Now I will discuss 3 and 5. Now our 5th topic. Instead of 3rd, 5th, I will start first. Conservation of forest. You have to find out its meaning. I think you know the meaning. Conservation of forest means what? Protect the forest from being depletion. Again, I repeat. Protect the forest from being depletion is called conservation of forest. In our textbook, this conservation part has given in a detailed way. Some methods of conservation given in the book. National forest policy given in the book. and some techniques also given in the book. So when you will write answer on this question conservation, very carefully you have to see the question. If it is about methods, you will write some points of methods. If it is about national policy, you will write from national policy. And if it is about techniques, so you will write technique. If the question comes, write some methods of conservation of forest given in the book. What are the national forest policy to conserve our forest given in the book? And what are the techniques to conserve the forest given in the book? So all points more or less same because related to this word. But before writing, you have to see the question. If you suppose question given methods of, write down the methods of conservation of forest and you are writing technique, it is not completely correct answer. So meaning or answer more or less said already, more or less same because it is related to conservation of forest. But before writing the answer, you see the question, it is about method or national forest policy or techniques. I am telling you some page number like methods. Methods of conservation of forest. It has given page number 58. That one you prepare at home. Then I will explain if is there any doubt. You first see page number 58. Many methods. I think from 1 to 6 methods given conservation of forest. National forest policy given page number 58 to 59. Total how many points given here? From 1 to 5 points given. So first you read, first you see what are the national forest policy, how many points are there, what points I have given here also. Then if is there any doubt, I will explain. But these two are different. Methods, simple methods given. Some methods through which we can conserve forest. National forest policy, yes, our government has taken this step. There are some steps given. Those steps are the part of forest policy. You prepare, then I will explain. And the last one is techniques. Some techniques we can follow for same purpose, conservation of forest. And in the book, only one technique has mentioned, that is social forestry. Only one technique given, that is social forestry. Social forestry is a technique through which we can conserve forest. So we have to know about the social forestry now. So now here I have mentioned social forestry. We have to know first the meaning. What is the meaning of social forestry? Then after one, two here I have written. Then we have to know what are the aims and objectives of this social forestry. Third, we have to know its classification. Social forestry can be divided into different categories. And last one, we have to know about problems faced in India's social forestry efforts. Everywhere it is not applicable or not applicable or not fruitful. Why? So these four things we have to learn from social forestry. First of all, what's the meaning? Meaning I have written here. Social forestry means looking after forest so as to protect the environment and meet the needs of people at the same time is called social forestry. Means we know forest give us many things. That's why like medicine, fruits, timber. So that's why we have to cut the forest. But if we cut the forest, there is another problem of depletion of forest. So what we have to do? If we cut forest, if we cut the trees side by side, we have to plant more trees. So we have to do two things. We have to protect the forest plus we have to fulfill our needs. That is part of social forestry. Now, aims of social forestry, objectives of social forestry, many are there. I have mentioned page number 59, given everything. Like, what are the objectives? To remove pressure from forest, then use maximum vacant land, then you can say the developing cottage industry. So these are the aims. Few points I said, many are there, and all points are very easy. So these are the aims of social forestry. You prepare any 4 points. Next, classification. This part is little bit broad, we can say, bigger than the last out of 4 points. Farm forestry, community forestry, extension forestry, and agro-based forestry. Social forestry can be divided into these 4 categories: farm forestry, community forestry, extension forestry, and agroforestry. Farm forestry means it is actually encourage the farmer to plant more trees in their farm. A very simple thing. Next one, community. They can plant, community forestry actually applicable in village area. There, government gives seeds, fertilizer, and many facilities to plant more trees in a open areas. Extension, almost same meaning. In village area, there are many vacant places are found. So, encourage the people to plant more trees and extend the limit of forest, that is extension forestry. And agro-based, the most important one. Here, farmer can do agriculture, rearing of animals, and planting trees, 3 works together, all together called agroforestry. This agroforestry out of these 4 is one of the important category. So, specifically for this forestry, we have to prepare its objectives and its advantages. What are the objectives of this agroforestry? Same thing, reduce the pressure of the forest, stop, check the soil erosion. These are the objectives and some advantages also. It has given you, first prepare few points. Page number I am writing. If it is not clear for you, then I will explain. Page number 60. So these are the 4 types of forestry. And the last one, problems faced in India's SF means social forestry. Also, page number I am writing here, only 2 points are there, very easy, 2 or 3 points are there. That one is awareness, lack of awareness is one of the problem. Then coordination problem between government and villagers. Then lack of information and infrastructure. So, these are the problems, that's why social forestry is not so successful in our country. So, these are the total topic about conservation of forest. Now, our 3rd topic, type of forest in India. It is completely homework, your part. You will complete this topic in your copy. Yes, copy. I think I didn't mention what type of copy you will use, because I think all of you know I prefer small size copy, 1 copy for everything, classwork and homework, but small in size, because small one easy to carry, or it can be, or you can use a ruled or practical copy, that is your choice. You can use ruled copy, you can use practical copy, but 1 copy small in size you will use. So it is your homework, which one you will do in that copy. Types of forest in India, we have 5 types of forest: tropical evergreen, tropical deciduous, thorn forest, littoral forest. Littoral forest has another name, mangrove or tidal. And the last one is mountain forest. your work is you have to find out the climatic condition of each forest. Climatic condition means everything. No, I have mentioned here. Just temperature and rainfall. So, you have to find out the temperature and rainfall amount of tropical evergreen forest and write down deciduous, thorn, like that way. Then you have to find out the characteristics of each type. But many points are there. How many we write? Any 3 points. Not more than 3. 3 characteristics for each type of forest you will write. And the location. First 2 names. I am writing here. First 2 locations or names for each type of forest. Means tropical evergreen forest is located in India where? First 2 locations you will mention, because everything has given in our book. So with the help of book you will fill up this table. It is your homework, plus it is our type of forest, because based on our climatic condition we are getting these 5 types of forest in our country. Clear? Now it is our second table. First table already I explained. That was your homework, types of forest in India. Now it is the second one, part of types of forest, same topic. Here what you have to do? Here you have to mention important trees which are found in this particular forest. 5 names I didn't write. 1 example I have written, tropical evergreen. Like that way you have to complete tropical deciduous 3, 4, 5. 3 means thorn forest, then littoral, then mountain. That is your work, your homework. 1 example I had shown, I have given here. First you will write all the types. Then important trees which are located in this forest. In this forest, evergreen forest, there are 3 important trees are located. Rosewood, sisam and gurzan. But here I have written location. In case of rosewood, we are getting locations. 2 locations are enough, I have mentioned. But sisam or shishu, we are not getting any location. So don't write. If you get, then write. Don't get, don't write. Gurzan, 2 locations given. So maximum 2 locations you will mention for each important tree. If you get. And then you will write use. Rosewood, use. Sisam, use. Gurzan, use. Everything given in the book. That is your work, your second table, your homework to find out the answer. Like this way, these 2 tables I want to see in your geography copy. Now the last part, homework part, because our chapter has completed natural vegetation. It is one of the small and easy chapter of our syllabus, my students. So last part, that is homework. Define the following terms. Total 10 terms I have given. Few I said, few you know. So you try to write that one. Littoral, tree line, Van Mahotsav, social forestry, agroforestry, afforestation, reafforestation, deforestation, natural vegetation and community forestry. You have to define these 10. And 2 homeworks already I had given, that is your 2, I have given, that is your 2 tables. And this one, write down the uses of these forest products. 4 products I have mentioned here. You have to write their uses only. Khush, gum, lac and resin. So now, our chapter has completed. Prepare all homework, copy, what type of copy I have already mentioned. So now, thank you.